I'm going to see that some more as I continue to try and match these different values. The next thing I'm going to do is try to make like a medium red for this middle section right here to help blend that shadow.
Okay, so I'm gonna stop the video there. I have a lot of work to do on this still. I'm gonna focus on just getting the values in place. I'm not concerned with like these little speckles or this line right here, any of those details, the highlights on the table. I know it's kind of hard to see with the reflection, but I'm not gonna add any of those details until I get my layers on the bottom built. So you have to think about a painting as being multiple layers. I'm just worried about getting the dark value on this side, the light value here, trying to get a smooth transition from dark to light. And I want you to notice, like, there is not a lot of paint on this palette. I started mixing with my brush a little bit, and that's fine if you want to do that because it helps you move a little faster. But don't get paint above the bristles. You don't want to get paint on this gold part. Otherwise, it's going to start getting all over your hands. It's going to make a giant mess, and you will not be able to work with paint anymore. I need you guys to make sure you are not using large amounts of paint, little drops at a time. The bottles will be on your table, so if you need more, you just get another drop. When you start to run out, try and keep your white and your black separate, because if they start to mix together, you're gonna start getting just gray. Everything will turn gray, and you don't want that to happen. So that's why it's important not to mix your white and your black. Even if you have red that has black in it, you don't want to put white into that. You want to keep any reds with blacks, try to keep them on this side of the palette, and any reds with white, keep them on that side of the palette. You want to keep white and black away from each other as much as possible. If it mixes a little bit while you're painting, you know, as you could see, I was starting to kind of blend on the painting with my paintbrush. That's not the end of the world, and you shouldn't have too many issues, but if you're mixing them together on the palette, you will have problems. So the first day of painting for this assignment, you're gonna have like full 90 minutes to paint. Hopefully you can get your entire base layer done. And if you need time, I'll give you guys 1 second day to start adding some of those details in your work, like if you have speckles and things like that. But really this is probably just gonna be a 2 day painting. Since it is so small, we're not going to spend more than 2 days on this assignment. All right, that's it.